Hi, and welcome to tonight's virtual graduation ceremony to celebrate the class of 2021 from Pritzker College Prep. While we were able to have an in-person ceremony, and we were so glad so many of you were able to be there, we did have to forego some of the usual traditions, which can be some of our most cherished and favorite parts of the night. The advisor speeches, who have been working with our students for 4 incredibly hard years, and the valedictorian and salutatorian speeches. So while you got to hear from me at your graduation, we wanted to make sure that you got to hear from all of our cherished support team and our student valedictorian and salutatorians this evening. I'm going to do that in Spanish here in a moment so that those that are listening in Spanish can hear me as well. Hola y bienvenidos a esta ceremonia, esta noche. Esto es maravillosa para celebrar nuestros graduados otra vez. Estábamos encantados de poder ofrecer una opción en persona en el 11 de junio. Y esta noche queremos asegurarnos que todas las tradiciones de Pritzker aún se pueden lograr a través de una ceremonia virtual, donde escuchará a nuestros oradores favoritos, sus asesores, el salutatorian y el valedictorian. Estábamos muy contentos de poder tener una ceremonia en persona, pero ninguna ceremonia estaría completa sin escuchar a estos fabulosos estudiantes y maestros. Déjame presentarte a dos estudiantes muy importantes, nuestro salutatorian y nuestro valedictorian. So our valedictorian this year is Yadira Lopez, who ended high school with a GPA of 4.78. She will be attending Northwestern University this fall, which is something that is very near and dear to her heart. She is not sure what she wants to major in, but I know she will do amazing with whatever it is that she chooses. Nuestra valedictorian Yadira Lopez, quien terminó la escuela secundaria con un GPA de 4.78, asistirá a la Universidad Northwestern este otoño. No está segura de en qué quiere especializarse, pero sé que lo hará en tiempos increíbles. Ella va a estar una estrella maravillosa allí.
Hello, staff, teachers, parents, and students of the class of 2021. What a year this has been. We had to face a challenge we were not prepared for while also being disconnected from friends and family. We sensed the loss of senior opportunities as well as final goodbyes to our teachers. We lost hope for a normal school year, but we fought on. We pulled through, enjoyed the small victories, reconnected through technology, and learned how to complete school online. We made it. Now, we are moving forward to the next stage of our lives. Bienvenidos, maestras, maestros, padres y estudiantes de la clase 2021. Nos encontramos con un obstáculo que nadie esperaba, pero llegamos al final de este año muy extraño. Sentimos la pérdida de los eventos de nuestro último año, pero luchamos contra las circunstancias. Hemos festejado las victorias, nos reconectamos por la tecnología y completamos el año escolar en línea. Ahora es tiempo de seguir a las siguientes etapas de nuestras vidas. Because of the pandemic and social isolation, we had all had time to reflect on our experiences. Therefore, I wanted to share a few takeaways to the class of 2021 in the form of an acrostic poem of the word graduate. Como hemos tenido tiempo para reflexionar durante la pandemia, me gustaría compartir unas palabras con los estudiantes de la clase 2021. Graduate. G. Give yourself time to reflect and rest. It's not all about the hustle. R. Radiate the energy and attitude you want others to have. A. Aim to leave this world a better place for future generations, whether that is through a small or large impact. D. Don't forget to stay true to yourself and your dreams. U. Understand that differences make us unique but should not act as a barrier for unity or support. A. Acceptance leads to kindness and unity and understanding. T. Take hold of new opportunities and use them to your advantage. E, education is available at any step in your individual journeys. Choose the path that is best for you. Overall, remember to be kind, empathetic people. You are all special and hold the generational power to change the world. Now, I would like to thank different groups of people. First, I would like to thank my family for the support they provided me through their words, stories, and radiating warmth. Gracias a mi familia por todo el apoyo. Second, I would like to thank my teachers. From the teachers that helped me transition into Pritzker to those that taught all of us life skills for the future, thank you. Thank you for pushing us forward in our thinking and giving us your support. Continue to inspire the next generation of students. Thank you to all my classmates throughout the years. Specifically, I would like to thank my IB cohort. It seems like we spent the majority of our years together. Thank you for the funny moments during English and history classes. Thank you for your vulnerability in our class conversations. Overall, I'm glad I got to meet such amazing people. I would also like to thank my advisor, Ms. Nelson, and my advisory. Thank you for the karaoke Thursdays, the advice, the laughs, and the fun times. I may not have started high school with all of you, but I will be ending it here together with everyone. Since we are at the end of this journey, I would like to share a quote from RM of BTS. During his UN speech, he said, "No matter who you are, where you're from, your skin color, or gender identity, speak yourself." His words and overall speech set an emphasis on the importance of learning to love your past self, to continue growing, and to step into your dreams. My hope is that you take these same lessons and remember them in your everyday life. These are my parting words to you all, and from the bottom of my heart, I wish everyone the best. Keep fighting and dreaming.
I'd also like to introduce you to our salutatorian. Her name is Emily Gonzalez. Emily ended high school with a GPA of a 4.7 and will be attending the University of Notre Dame this fall to study architecture. We are so proud of Emily and Yadira. We know that they will both bring lots of pride to themselves, their families, and their community. La salutatorian, Emily Gonzalez, quien terminó la escuela secundaria con un GPA de 4.70, asistirá a la Universidad de Notre Dame este otoño para estudiar la arquitectura.
Welcome to all family and friends. Bienvenidos a todos los padres, alumnos y familiares. It is a pleasure to have you join us tonight to celebrate the class of 2021 as we come together to conclude its irreplicable high school journey. 4 years ago, we were all finishing the eighth grade and about to embark on a very similar journey. High school. We were all scouting the city to find that one school that fit us the best. And for me, I thought that high school would be Lane Tech. And I tell you this because all throughout middle school, I did really well. I just didn't do good enough on the selective enrollment exam to actually make it into the school I really, really wanted to go to. And along the lines, somehow I ended up here at Pritzker. And look at me now. But what does this all mean? Let me take you back to the summer of 2019 when I first flew solo to chase the dream. There I was, guiding myself past the TSA checkpoint, only looking back to wave goodbye to my family one last time. There I was. Never had I flown across the country alone. Never had I gone this long without my family. And never had I felt this fulfilled. But I mean, how could I not be? I was about to touch forbidden grounds. I was about to study at the Stanford University. But some of you might look at me and say, hadn't you always been academically successful? Shouldn't you have expected this opportunity to come knocking on your door eventually? Well, you see, I, a Mexican-American girl, was not raised like the average female in the United States. I was born to the tortillas hechas a mano, menudo on Sunday mornings, and the luscious dark brown hair con la piel color caramelo. I grew up seeing the world with a little extra green, white, and red. And this meant that I was growing up in a country where minorities, like you and me, weren't destined to be great, to go to college, or to make change. So you can only imagine my thrill when, just as a sophomore in high school, I already had the chance to study at Stanford University. But it wasn't always like that. This was never something I was handed. Aunque fui nacida en los Estados Unidos, mi primer lenguaje fue el español. Mi primer año completamente en inglés fue el quinto año de la primaria, y antes de eso, año tras año, mis clases eran en español o bilingües. Yo me acuerdo estar año tras año en la única clase en cual hablaba en el español, y cómo los otros estudiantes se me quedaban viendo como si yo no pudiera avanzar al mismo nivel que ellos solo porque yo hablaba el español. Yo llegué de tener que traducirle a mi papá el menú de cada restaurante americano que íbamos, a poder traducirle todos los nombres de las universidades que me aceptaron. Ser hija de un inmigrante requiere un esfuerzo inimaginable. Desde niña yo escuchaba mi papá irse a trabajar todos los días a las 3 de la mañana. Desde niña yo escuchaba las historias de cómo mi papá sufría solo por querer ir a la escuela, por querer una educación. Y desde niña yo me prometí luchar a lograr todo lo que mi papá quería por mí y por sí mismo cuando logró llegar a este país. Llegar a estudiar en el colegio en solo mi segundo año de la secundaria fue una realización que nunca me esperaba. En ese momento cambió mi perspectiva completamente. En ese momento yo entendí que sí se pueden lograr los sueños por cual unos luchan lograr sin que se importe de dónde vienes. En ese momento, yo entendí que una mujer, especialmente una mujer mexicana, sí puede cambiar el mundo. And from the moment I realized I could, I never stopped. The moment I realized I held the power in my hands to mold my future, change the way people saw me, and become someone, was the moment I continued to hold on to. And this is why ending up at Pritzker was the best thing that could have happened to me, which is really strange to say. But I say it because it wasn't what I wanted or what I planned. And that's what forced me to open my eyes, take charge, and pave the future I wanted for myself. So if you take absolutely anything away from this, I want it to be this. Today is the day our lives begin. Today we become citizens of the world. Today we become grown-ups. Today we become accountable for someone other than ourselves and our parents, accountable for more than just our grades. Today we become accountable to the world, to the future, to all the possibilities that life has to offer. Starting today, our job is to show up wide-eyed, willing, and ready. For what? I don't know. For anything and for everything. To take on life, to take on love, to take on the possibilities and responsibilities. Take hold of your future. Know that the power to become who you want to be and do what you want to do is all in your hands. No importa de dónde vienes o cuántos obstáculos se presenten, tú puedes lograr más de lo que te imaginas. Y no dejes que nadie te diga que no. Today, my friends, our lives begin, and I, for one, can't wait. I wish you all the happiness, success, and good fortune that you all really do deserve. It's been a pleasure, and don't forget, pequeños momentos se convierten en grandes recuerdos. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Gracias por venir esta noche. Gracias por escuchar. Thank you for coming. Thank you for tuning in. We hope you enjoy what's in store.
Hello, lovelies. You did it. You're graduating. When you walked into Pritzker as a freshman, the class of 2021, no one had a clue that your graduation year would be beyond out of the ordinary. I am so proud of you. You've accomplished so much. You are all extraordinary. Before you take off onto your next adventure, I want to leave you with my hopes for the future for each of you. I hope you always keep moving forward. Espero que siempre sigas avanzando. I hope you learn from everything. Espero que aprendas de todo. I hope you dream big, really big. Espero que sueñas grande, realmente en grande. I hope you're prepared to trust your instincts. Espero que estés preparada para confiar en tus instintos. I hope you focus on discovering yourself. Espero que te concentres en conocerte a ti mismo. I hope you love yourself as much as I love you. Espero que te ames como yo te amo. I hope you don't hide from your mistakes. Espero que no te escondas de tus errores. And I hope you never forget where you came from. Espero que nunca olvides de dónde vienes. Stephanie Alvarado. Citlali Alvarez. Annabelle Arevalo. Kaylee Ariaza. Jennifer Alicia Arroyo. Destiny Baca. Joanna Baena. Melanie Baena. Yasmin Baena. Alondra Baena Gutierrez. Galilea Bautista. Angelica Bernabe. Vanessa Guadalupe Bernal Ramon. Jasmine Bustamante. America Calvario. Faith Campuzano. Arlette Carino. Tanaris Casillas. Michelle Catalan. Adamaris Cazares. Alma Fernanda Cerón. Mayari Chester.
When thinking about how to best prepare this speech and what mind-blowing advice I could give you as you enter the next stage of your life, I decided that I'd turn to the professionals. Who are they, you ask? Freshman year you. Remember those letters that you wrote to yourself 4 years ago? The ones you told me that I lose before you graduate? I didn't lose them. And before you leave Pritzker for the final time, I wanted to remind you of some of the goals that you set for yourself as freshman in high school. Number one, at the end of high school, I will have a girlfriend, and that's a fact. Number two, right now, my handwriting is terrible, so hopefully that gets better over time. Number three, how many push-ups can you do by now? It's a great question. I'm curious as to what the answer is. Number four, you should be right and left-handed because you started practicing on September 8th, 2017. Number five, remember the color of your toothbrush. After providing some very entertaining commentary, you moved on to talk about your goals after high school. A handful of you mentioned wanting a better world. Some of you mentioned living a happy life. The vast majority of you mentioned attending college and starting your career. And almost all of you mentioned becoming successful. If you take anything away from this speech, let it be this. The coolest part about success is that you get to decide what it means. If you're unhappy with where you are, you have the power to do something about it. You are the agent of change in your life. Whatever the next step is in your journey, I hope you make the most of it. Make mistakes and grow from them. Ask for help when you need it. Try things that make you uncomfortable. Learn from people, especially those who are smarter than you. Treat everyone you meet with respect. Stay hydrated. Be wary of 3-in-1 shampoo, conditioner, body wash combos, because remember, you have skin and hair that also need to be nourished. Laugh uncontrollably, stay humble, and above all else, be kind. If the last year and a half has taught us anything, it is to love fiercely and without restriction. In the conclusion of the letter to yourself, one of you said, good luck on the rest of your life, but you don't need luck. I know you can handle whatever life throws at you, because I've watched you do it for the past 4 years, and I know you'll do it for the next four and beyond. If you're ever struggling, have a great story to tell, or need some tough love, you know where to find me.
Jamie Aguilar, Nicholas Aguirre, Marcel Alfaro, Alexis Arroyo, Orlando Arroyo, Jonathan Avila, Elias Badillo, Angel Bailon, Juan Barrera, Alejandro Batalla, Brandon Beltran, Angel Bizarres, Christian Bisono, Richard Brujito, Marco Cambrone, Alejandro Carvajal, Victor Cayetano, Steven Chacha, Gregorio Chavez, Jose Chavez, Jose Colon III, Miguel Cordero, Edgar Corrales, Kevin Lima.
Ladies, 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 ladies. Okay, whew. Now that I've got your attention, there are a few things that I would like to say. So, first and foremost, it has been my absolute honor and to be your advisor for the past 4 years. Nevertheless, she persisted. This phrase was born out of a man trying to silence a woman's voice, but you have taken this phrase and done just the opposite. For if you had not persisted, you would not be here at this moment graduating high school. You are a group of young women who have embodied this phrase more than any of us could have imagined. You have overcome obstacles and have celebrated victories. I have been constantly impressed by how you have supported one another. In watching all your hard work together, it became obvious to me that you understood that just because someone else was succeeding didn't mean that you couldn't succeed also. There is enough room for everyone to flourish. You're my first advisory, and because of that, each of you will always hold a special place in my heart. I am incredibly thankful that we fit so much into the first 2.5 years of our time together. Zoo lights, potlucks, dance class, woman of the week, decorating for the holidays, and Pritzker Goes Pink fundraisers all are things that hopefully you will carry with you in your memories going forward. I will be retiring, nevertheless, she persisted, as my advisory motto. But you must take that quote and continue to live it as you become the nurses, teachers, cosmetologists, architects, x-ray techs, and neuroscientists, the leaders of the future. Now more than ever, our country and world need intelligent, hardworking, articulate individuals, and you are, without a doubt, those people. I will leave you with the words from one of the greatest authors ever, William Shakespeare. All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players, and they have their exits and entrances, and one woman in her time plays many parts. Your graduation is your official exit into your next act in life. With love, adoration, admiration, and respect, congratulations. Desiree Cordova, Adriani Cornejo, Yamilet Correa, Cassidy Crespo, Brianna Daniels, Marlene D'Angelo, Carla De Leon, Hema Delgado, Helen Delgado, Ariel Dominguez, Jocelyn Dominguez, Itzel Estrada, Andrea Fajardo, Yaxenia Famania, Angeli Finley, Leilani Flores, Brianna Garcia, Crystal Garcia, Fatima Garcia, Yahaira Garcia, Emily Gonzalez, Isis Gonzalez, Alexa Goreka, Elizabeth Gutierrez, Analia Lopez, Nyalicia Montañez.
Everybody stop. I would like to begin with an idea from the Russian novelist and social activist Leo Tolstoy's book, A Calendar of Wisdom, which we used to read out loud in advisory together. This particular quote is from June 11th, and it reads as follows, quote, "All external changes that take place in our lifetimes are insignificant when compared with those changes that take place in our way of thinking," end quote. I'm proud to say that I have observed many profound changes in the way all of you think. When we began this journey 4 years ago, the U.S. national debt was at a whopping $19.6 trillion. And now, 4 years later, it stands at a jaw-dropping $28.4 trillion. Also, when we first met, I asked you a question. Why do we even have public schools? We return to that question over and over again, and we did so by addressing a wide variety of issues, from whether college athletes should be able to be compensated and paid through endorsements, to how the Congolese should protect their wild mountain gorillas from exploitative and greedy fossil fuel companies. We explored the idea that perhaps school is not for your entertainment, and we talked about how to read the room wherever we may be. We pumped our fists together. We made lots of insane noise. We yelled, especially when Ms. Johnson came into the room. And we laughed maniacally. And we even meditated. Well, some of us did. Instead of watching Disney films that were written for the masses, we analyzed strange horror films featuring two weird guys wearing short white shorts, carrying golf balls and smashing eggs. We also deeply analyzed Godfrey Reggio's film Koyani Skotsi, the Hopi word meaning life out of balance. And perhaps that has been the theme of this advisory, that is, to discuss exactly why this world is out of balance, and how also you might restore some balance. Some of you discussed, for example, going on to college to achieve epic transformations by building generational wealth. And I can't wait to see that. In any case, I believe that all of you have undergone a transformation in your thinking that Tolstoy talks about in his quote. And now it is time for you to go through the threshold into the next phase of your lives. Now, as an ultimate sign of approval and affirmation of your achievements, I would like to invite all of you who are watching to participate in a Stossberg ritual of praise and knock on a hard surface wherever you are with enthusiasm. Aaron Cuevas, Noah Davis, Fernando de la Torre, Gabriel Delgado Valentin, Eminel Delgado, Jason Delgado, Kelvin Dominguez, Steven Escogido, Milton Espino, Carlos Espinoza, Hugo Estrada, Edwin Estrada, Edwin Flores, Matthew Flores, Josue Garcia, Alexander Gonzaga, Christian Gonzalez, Luis Gonzalez, Victor Gonzalez, Jonathan Guadarrama, Jesus Guerrero, Christian Gutierrez, Edgar Heredia, Oswaldo Hernandez, Abraham Juazano Padilla, Antoine Johnson, Nathan Lagunas, Joel Legorreta, Noelmi Lizardo.
When you were freshmen, I started a file on my computer called Advisory Speech. I recently opened it and saw two things. Cake story, the meaning of life. In advisory a few weeks ago, I asked you what you wanted included in your graduation speech, and you responded, cake story, meaning of life. All right. So a few years ago, we were watching something in advisory with the lights off. I heard a crinkling across the room and saw a wrapper drop to the floor. Hey, you all know the rules about candy. You can't have it during school. Whose wrapper is this? One of you, and I remember who, but I won't call you out, fessed up right away. I said, I'm sorry, you know we can't have sweet stuff during advisory, especially secret sweet stuff. You were cool with it, and I thought to myself, yeah, you handled that well. A few minutes later, one of Miss Killian's advisees knocked on our door. It was Miss Killian's birthday, and they were having a party with cake. The student held out a paper plate with a huge piece of cake on it and a few strawberries on the side, you know, to balance it out. She handed it to me with a sweet, "Miss Nelson, this is for you." I thanked her. You were silent. She left, the door clicked shut, and you went nuts. Suddenly, 24 voices were screaming at me, "That's not fair, that's like candy. Why do you get a treat and we don't?" Certain I could continue my streak of patience and responsibility, I tried to calmly explain about how there was fruit on the plate, how it wasn't secret cake like the candy was secret, how it was a birthday, and what was I supposed to say to that student? You kept screaming, "Not fair, not fair." I'd been teaching for many years and prided myself on always remaining calm and patient. I never raised my voice. I never lost it. I was Miss Nelson, calm and relaxed. But as you know, I snapped. "Fine, no one gets cake." I crumpled the paper plate in my hand, totally demolishing the cake, and threw it in the trash. You looked at me with wide eyes and the bell rang. I raced out of the room across the hall so I could tell my side of the story first, and so I could avoid looking at you anymore. We are an intense advisory, passionate, vocal, hilarious, and today, in celebration of 4 years of the sweatshirtless Nelson advisory, I will finally get my cake. I'm ready for it. All right. And as promised, I would like to leave you with the meaning of life. You've been asking for this since the first day of freshman year. So here I go. Sorry.
Jasmaya Heredia, Julissa Hernandez, Melissa Hernandez, Eileen Huerta, Melanie Jacobo, Karime Hieranimo, Savannah Laluz, Kayla LaSalle, Sidlali Leva, Wendy Licardi, Ariana Lopez, Yadira Lopez, Michelle Lucario, Anai Maldonado, Anna Martinez, Everling Martinez, Jeanette Martinez, Skyla Martinez, Jamie Matias, Jacqueline Mazzone, Itzel Melendez, Rosa Mendez, Citlali Mendoza, Jarissa Mirabal Paredes.
Roscoe wins for best hair. Nathan's got a story share. George hates Captain Marvel, so you'll veto, he'll condone.
Manny had a total blast. Went for trivia, we were last. Justin Miller's quiet on a level all his own.
Adrian, he joined us late, but he fits in really great. Lester liked RO, but never did our CPU.
Esteban, he likes to skate. Juan goes fishing at the lake. Aiden's dad was super cool, while Aiden's legs are askew.
Outside of band and choir, we could watch you grow up every time you'd show up. Outside of band and choir, I used to be a hater, now it's 4 years later.
Gio turned his grades around, Ricky plays with plunky sound, Adrian got better at delivering Google slides.
Jason could convince us all that his interests weren't banal, Mondra again will feed off of political divides.
Since the first of freshman year, Osvaldo's kept it all in gear. Who will build the risers now that Brian's not around?
Lio came from Super Day, Fernando's here still in a wave. One thing that we won't miss is that horrible cat sound. Outside of band and choir, we would watch you grow up every time you'd show up. Outside of band and choir, I used to be a hater, now it's 4 years later. Ephraim solid every day,
Eric's gonna go his way,
with a C or with a K,
how could we forget Jose?
Outside of band and choir, we would watch you grow up every time you'd show up. Outside of band and choir, I used to be a hater, now it's 4 years later.
Adrian Araña, Lester Madrid, Jaden Maldonado, Esteban Manguilla, Jose Martinez, Osvaldo Medina, Emmanuel Mendoza, Justin Miller, Omar Miranda, Aiden Molina, David Mondragon, Eric Morales, Adrian Munoz, Giovanni Murillo, Juan Nunez, Matthew Nunez, Vicente Ocampo, Efren Oliva, David Orozco, Ricardo Ortega Jr., Fernando Palacios, David Pelayo, Jose Perez Andrade, Nathan Picula, George Quiñones, Brian Ramirez, Eric Ramirez, Jason Villavicencio,
To the ladies of the Young Advisory, congratulations on graduating high school. What an amazing accomplishment this is. Even though the last year and a half was different than we expected, you were always a constant in my life. You always made me laugh and put a smile on my face. I looked forward to hearing from each and every one of you throughout our school closure. When I got asked to join Ms. Killian's advisory at the start of your sophomore year, I had no idea what to expect. But throughout the years, you girls constantly impressed me, and I am always in awe of your humbleness and your accomplishments. I remember our first day together. Let's just say that the looks on your faces showed that you weren't sure about having another advisor. While I'm happy to share that throughout our 3 years together, our bond blossomed and I couldn't have wished to be an added advisor to a better group of women. I have loved the memories and traditions that we have created together. Some of my favorite memories and traditions include our daily chats, weekly community circles, our door decorating, our holiday parties, our t-shirt making, our student of the week, our daily treats, our Friday lunches, and our movie watching parties. You girls might not realize, but you have all taught me so much, and I will keep these things with me for the rest of my teaching career. You taught me that putting 20 plus high school girls in a room is extremely loud. You have taught me that freshmen that once didn't know each other turn into a close family. You have taught me that even when you give each other, and me sometimes, a hard time, you mean well. You have taught me that your hard work pays off. You have taught me that you are the strongest individuals that I've ever met. You have taught me to never give up. You have taught me some of the most important lessons, and for that, I thank you. I cannot think about Pritzker and what it's going to be like without each of you and your ridiculous personalities walking through our hallways. But I know that you are each going to shine so bright in the next chapter of your life. I cannot wait to hear and see all the amazing things that you all accomplish. I know you are each the future of our world, our future doctors, teachers, nurses, lawyers, social workers, therapists, and much more. Please continue to keep in touch after you leave Pritzker. Keep me updated on your life and all of the amazing accomplishments. And most important, always know I'm here for you. In my famous words, reach out if you need anything. Catherine Lim. Julissa Mojica. Alexa Morante. Montserrat Munoz. Daniela Ocana. Sandra Ordas. Ariana Padilla. Kendra Paredes. Dawn Payne. Yadira Peralta. Stephanie Perez. Mikayla Person. Mirna Pineda. Natalie Prudente. Katia Ramirez. Maradeli Reyes. Jaylene Rivera. Lizbeth Robles. Ashley Rodriguez. Leslie Roman.
Sound is good.
Let me see. Can I lift it like a little bit?
Congratulations, the Labor Pool Advisory, and to all the other Pritzker graduates. You did it. You are at the end of your high school journey, ready to start a new one, college. Before you embark into this new terrain, I want to acknowledge that this year was tough and unprecedented. This year reminds me of a quote, "The harder the conflict, the more glorious the triumph." Today, you triumph. You did it. You are here, graduating because you persevered. 2020 was full of obstacles that seemed almost impossible to overcome, but you persisted and are here today dressed in your caps and gowns. You should be so proud of yourself. I am so excited to see what's next for you. I know you will go out into this world and do great things. Congrats again, graduates. Thank you.
So the Label Pool Advisory, I can't believe we're here. I still remember the first day in our freshman year when we all met you all. Me and Ms. Leba didn't know what to do, but we knew that we can stick through and that we had a great group of girls. As the years went on, we have seen you all grow, become more mature, make good choices, and excel in academics. I am extremely proud to stand here to say that I am your advisor and that I have seen you guys mature and grow in such a great way. Congratulations, you guys have did it. And always remember, no matter what accomplishments you make, someone always helps you. In the words of Wilma Rudolph, we have helped you on this journey, and we know that you will continue to grow and be strong.
Pals forever!
Karen Fonseca.
Jaylene Yamas.
Monica Rodriguez.
Erica Romo.
Jennifer Rosales. Odalis Ruelas.
Abigail Salgado.
Melissa Salgado.
Anna Cristina San Juan.
Angelica Sanchez.
Silali Sanchez.
Desiree Sanchez.
Delaney Santiago.
Kylie Shanna.
Maria Timigan.
Jocelyn Torres. Raven Valladares.
Esmeralda Vargas.
Jahira Vega.
Elizabeth Velasquez.
Jalissa Villalobos.
Evelyn Visne.
Graduation speeches are often filled with quotes that are meant to inspire the graduates before they embark on their next life adventure. A quick Google search will offer thousands of quotes from politicians, athletes, celebrities, all with a handful of carefully composed motivational words meant to offer the keys to success, inspiration, and happiness. So, as you graduate today, we, too, want to leave you with one of our own. Nothing we say to you today matters.
Before you assume this is the worst graduation speech of all time, consider this. Many of you are first-generation college students. You have spent almost half of your high school career in the midst of a global pandemic. Some of you have balanced working jobs, taking care of siblings, and dealing with a variety of other obstacles throughout your time at Pritzker. And you've made it. You're here. There is no quotation, no catchy phrase that should inspire you as much as the work you've already done and the perseverance that you've already shown. So, if you find yourself in need of some inspiration in the future, we don't want you to look to the internet or a poster. Instead, look in a mirror. Because when we look at all of you and see the hardworking, compassionate, and kind human beings you have become, we are wholly inspired. When you look in that mirror, we hope you are too.
So, I know we literally just told you that nothing we say to you matters, and therefore we apologize for contradicting ourselves now. But if you do stare at yourself in the mirror and find that you still need a little extra push to keep going, we hope you remember this. You are enough. You belong. And most importantly, we love you.
As sad as we are to see you go, we're so proud of what you've already accomplished and what we know you will accomplish in the future. You are all an inspiration to us, and you will forever hold a special place in our hearts. Congratulations to the Pritzker College Prep Class of 2021.
Marco A. Garcia, Daniel Reyes, David Roman, Ivan Roman, Emilio Romo, Salvador Rosas, Edwin Rosendo, Thomas Salado, Alexander Salgado, Argenis Salgado, Daniel Sanchez, Jason Sanchez, Ivan Santian,
Adrian Silva, Jesus Silverio, Deshaun Singleton, Alejandro Solis,
Gustavo Soto,
Arturo Suarez, Emiliano Torres, Uriel Torres, Amarion Townsend, Jeremiah Velasquez, Keon Velasquez.
Class of 2021, congratulations. I am so proud of you. We are all incredibly proud of you. You all are magnificent, tenacious, and incredible human beings. I know it hasn't been easy finishing your high school career in the midst of a pandemic. The last 18 months have turned our lives upside down. But what I have observed from you, class of 2021, is your commitment to overcoming what is in your way, your commitment to becoming whoever it is that you want to be, and your awesome ability to do whatever it takes in order to accomplish your dreams. Over the next few weeks, you're going to get a lot of advice from family, friends, and loved ones about your future. And I have just one thing I want you to hold on to as you embark on this next chapter after high school. I want you to know that you can do anything, and specifically, I want you to never tell yourself no. This spring, in addition to my responsibilities as CEO of Noble, I taught a class on leadership to a group of Noble students from various schools. My goal was for students to learn that leadership skills already exist within each one of us and can be harnessed through our stories. And what I learned was that many of our students, despite their incredible strength, courage, and all the wisdom that they have gained from navigating life experiences, still continue to doubt themselves. I've been there. In 2005, I started applying to graduate school to earn a Master of Business Administration, or MBA. As part of that process, I had to take a standardized test, the GMAT, much like the SAT for admission. I took that GMAT at least 5 times, and I just could not get the score that I needed for the schools I wanted to attend. I was devastated. I remember going to my grandma's house in Hollister, North Carolina, where my family is from, on Christmas Day that year and talking with one of my cousins, Will. Will knew that I had been talking about going to graduate school for years, and so he asked me how I was going. I told him that I had submitted a few applications, but I wasn't going to apply to Harvard, which was my dream school, because my test scores just weren't good enough. He then shared a few words with me that seriously changed my entire life. He said, "Constance, don't you ever tell yourself no. If anything, apply and let them tell you no, but you owe it to yourself to try. Do not ever tell yourself no." Well, I hustled and I completed my application in a couple days, which I don't recommend, by the way, if you can prevent it. I got that application in and I was accepted into Harvard's MBA program, which is the number one MBA program in the world. The experience of attending Harvard Business School literally changed my entire life. But that experience almost did not happen because I had told myself no, that I was not good enough, that I didn't have a chance, that I was not worthy. I have lived my life by the words my cousin shared with me that day. Do not tell yourself no. There's going to be a lot of people in this world that, despite your awesomeness and your brilliance, will tell you no because they don't want you at the table, because they don't think you're good enough, or they might even be threatened by your presence. So I need you to tell yourself yes. I need you to be your own biggest fan. I need you to be courageous and to take the chance and try. Apply for that job or internship. Submit that proposal. Run for president of that student organization. Be bold, be courageous. You have already demonstrated that you are more than enough, that you are conquerors. Now I need you to tell yourself yes, and to first and foremost, believe in yourself. And also, surround yourself with other people. In this case, it was my cousin Will, who are going to fill your cup, lift you up, and affirm that you belong and you can do this. And if you can't find people who will fill your cup, know that you will always be a part of our Noble family, and we will always be cheering you on, supporting you in any way we can. You inspire me, and there are so many people here that are inspired by you, and we will always have your back. I cannot wait to see what you have in store for the world. We love you. We are so proud of you. Congratulations, class of 2021.